So it's very critical that we have a high level of compliance because, you know, cannabis is still Schedule One. So we've had to work very closely, and it's taken us a long time to get our contracts with private payors, Medicare and Medicaid, and to incorporate this treatment model in a compliant way. But we have been really focused, laser focused on growing that insurance reimbursement revenue.
All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Tim Pickett. He is the founder of KindlyMD. And Tim, it's good to see you. How are you?
I'm great, Steve. How are you?
I'm doing very well, thanks. And good to have you along. Excited to learn a bit more about what's going on within the company. And you've had some recent news out. We'll talk about it in just a second. But maybe give me a bit of background on the company.
Well, KindlyMD was started as really a behavioral integration group. We use an integrated behavioral health model where we incorporate traditional doctor's visits with behavioral health at the point of care. And then we incorporate alternative medicine as well where needed to help people get off of their opioids.
Yeah. And obviously that's a tremendous need. I don't think you've been anywhere in North America without hearing the story of just how rampant opioid abuse is and the problems that we're seeing with it. Obviously you've seen that and looking for an alternative here.
Yeah. We're trying to help patients and really grow a system that doesn't, you know, is not focused on procedures. It's not focused on increasing the drug use or the prescriptions. It really helps people lower the burden of opioids. It helps people get back to their lives. And we think we can do that and make money as a healthcare company as well and benefit investors and really grow this company to change the view of the opioid epidemic and really help people.
Yeah. Let's talk a little bit about the company first, and that is that you've just recently had a successful IPO. Talk about taking you to that level and really what that does for KindlyMD.
So the story of, you know, going to the public markets was really important for us because we're using medical cannabis in our treatment protocols in a federally compliant way. And that story with the opioid epidemic, the capital markets are good for expanding the story and helping us roll up other interventional pain clinics and primary care clinics in an acquisition strategy to grow our base of patients and grow a little faster. So we completed that IPO just at the end of May. We started trading May 31st, and we're really excited to get that strategy going, talking to a robust, you know, list of acquisition targets and really start to make an impact in this, you know, in this interventional, this integrated behavioral health model that we do.
Yeah. Let's talk about your financial numbers. You just recently put out your Q2 numbers and saw a really significant increase, over 160%, in fact. And a lot of that is due to insurance companies really saying, hey, this is an alternative that we can get behind.
So yes, it's very critical that we have a high level of compliance because, mm-hmm. you know, cannabis is still Schedule One. So we've had to work very closely, and it's taken us a long time to get our contracts with private payors, Medicare and Medicaid, and to incorporate this treatment model in a compliant way. But we have been really focused, laser focused on growing that insurance reimbursement revenue, which we've seen, yes, like you said, 164% increase quarter over quarter in that particular segment of our company, which that is the long-term success of the company. It legitimizes our program. And as we look to Schedule 3, cannabis being rescheduled from Schedule 1 to Schedule 3, that should only enhance our ability to expand and help more patients.
Yeah, Tim, let's look ahead now, next 3-6 a year out. What are sort of the main things that you'd like to see the company accomplishing over that time frame?
We'd like to expand primarily in Utah and then start to look to other states after that time frame. So the initial plan is to really grow our footprint here in Utah. There's a lot of opportunity for acquisition here in the pain space. There's a lot of opportunity to help people with their opioid problem, grow at least one new clinic ourselves, acquire at least one or two clinics over the next, you know, short term, and then look to go out of state into a multi-state expansion.
Well, it is an exciting time for your team and for yourself as well. It sounds like things are going to be very interesting over the next few months, and we look forward to continuing to follow your story as well, Tim. Thanks very much. Good to see you, and appreciate the time.
Yeah, thanks, Steve. Take care.
All right. There is Tim Pickett, the founder of KindlyMD.